So here we are into Justin's vanity election, and a lot of people are talking about it, but you will not get here what you're going to get in the mainstream news because they're just going to go blah, 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 blah. We are going to go on to specific issues, and Jenny Byrne, who is a much sought-after consultant and a really, really hands-on conservative, is joining me right now. I was going to say hands-on. You're still a conservative.
100%, of course.
And there's no question about that. Let's talk about the conservative media. Conservatives always say the media in Canada is all liberal. And I saw a story the other day. It just said, you know, that the conservatives are fighting themselves over the platform. I mean, liberals are fighting themselves over Justin. I mean, but you won't see an article over that. Mm-hmm. Is the media in Canada essentially liberal?
Well, I think there's probably some elements of that.
Ones that are paid by the liberals?
That's a whole other issue for another day. But I've had my liberal friends complain about the coverage of Premier Ford at the Queen's Park Gallery, and he's an obvious conservative premier. So I think that I think there could be bias within certain elements of the media, but it is what it is.
It is what it is. And another thing about the media, though, if anybody is so silly to watch a press conference, you do, I do, it's our business, but most people don't. But they see, for instance, Trudeau moving on a campaign trail, and somebody will ask the same question two or three times. He will not answer it.
Yes.
He will just say, we are here to build jobs and make Canadians' lives easier. And what do you think about the death penalty? We are here to make lives easier. Like, no matter what the question, he gets that. How does the press let him get away with that?
Well, I think, I don't remember it being quite like that when I was back working in politics for Prime Minister Harper, or before that, Preston Manning, when he was the Reform Party leader. I think that it's probably just even a practical thing. Reporters get one or two questions now when it comes to press conferences, and everyone has kind of their own agenda, their own story that they're following. So the media kind of they ask the question and then they take the answer.
Are you suggesting that the media is getting hung on their own petard? Should they have just a simple question, Justin Trudeau, do you think XYZ?
Yeah, well, that's what I would do, but I'm not a member of the media.
And you do very well by that, by not being a member of the media. Do you think that we need a sharper media, or is the fact that, you know, CBC, CTV, Global, Post Media are all subsidized, Toronto Star are all subsidized by the Liberal government, does that really impact upon the news?
Well, I think Canadians are more and more getting their news from alternative sources. I can't remember the last time I picked up a paper newspaper. And so there's so many different blogs and different news aggregators that people are getting their news from that they're bypassing what would be the mainstream media. And we've seen campaigns reach out. You look at the Ford campaign in 2018. They had very little media interaction where they went direct to voters. They did a direct messaging right to their supporters.
You're absolutely right. Jenny Byrne, that reminds me. PayPal, keep us on. Thank you. So now we are in the middle of Justin's vanity election, and all over mainstream news, you're going to have the same news day after day after day. We are not going to have every show between now and September 20th on the election. We are going to have some very, very important analysis and some smart ideas and thoughts that you will not find anywhere else, hence PayPal, please. But I just want to lay it out for you that we will also be having some people in on this show who are not big names, who have something to say about the issues. Because when it comes down to it, elections are not about the people so much, it's about the issues, how it impacts you. Stay tuned. We're going to have some good ones.